Hi guys, welcome to QM Chronicles once again. If it's your first time joining us, we say welcome. Kindly click on the subscribe button and turn on your post notification. And please, please, like I always say, kindly drop a comment on the comment section if you like this video or not. And if you're joining us another time and you're like a frequent visitors, you guys know that you're the real VIPs. And I say thank you guys for the love. I'm just going to go straight into the topic. And today we are talking about modeling. Yeah, how to become a model in 2021, especially in Port Harcourt. How to actually become a successful model. Let me put it that way. Yeah, like a successful model or a recognized model. I think it's a better sentence for me. Yeah. How to become a recognized model in 2021, especially in this crazy city of Port Harcourt. It's not a cool journey, like it's not a very slow journey, but it's something that when you put your mind to it and the passion is there, the interest is there, and you know you're ready to work. Because some people just see these things like you go in front of the camera, you're catching fun, and people are just admiring you, and you tell yourself you're busy. Sometimes I tell people, try out yourself. Just the smallest confidence to even stand in front of camera. Some people don't have it. Talk less of when you have to walk the runway or when you have to like be ambassadors for brands. Like that takes a whole lot of confidence, a whole lot of training, so to say. So becoming a successful or a recognized model in 2021, especially in Port Harcourt, let's just dive right into it. And the first thing I would say is, you've got to join an agency, an academy, a modeling agency. It's quite important for you to be discovered. Now, you see a lot of people saying, I'm a freelance model. I tell you, for me, anyone who picks up a phone and you can actually strike a pose and snap your phone, you're already a model. In fact, you're a freelance model. So for me, I feel like the freelance modeling thing is quite a scam. Because to be a trained model, there is nothing you want to do that you don't have to go through constant learning, constant practice, constant training to make sure you perfect it. Because how would you get to professionality if you're not trained through a process? So you definitely have to be in an agency, in an academy. Now, it's a dicey thing. Now, I'm just going to come here so everybody don't just say, oh, all these academies are a scam. You go there, they'll just do rehearsals. Yes, I've actually had such experience too. Like you join an academy and all you just do is rehearsals. You don't have classes, you don't have lectures on what you should know and things you should not know. I virtually paid extra money to have those lectures with another academy. Now, if you notice, I use the word an academy, I use the word an agency. Most agencies just take people. You don't even have to register to join an agency. You just start up rehearsals, join people, they'll tell you, catch up and all. But for modeling, I always advise you join an academy. Like, you just start with this schooling part of it. The do's and the don'ts, the things you should know and the things you shouldn't know, the things you should be careful about, the things you should go for. But that actually gives you a direction of what part of modeling suits you perfectly and should put a lot more energy or interest into. So I feel like you definitely have to be an agency who's going to help you project your own self. It's not all their responsibility to project you. You've got to be doing assignments on yourselves too. But trying to discover an agency, please always ask questions. Ask for their past results. Ask models who are already with them. Try to find out projects they've carried out, things that they've done, how much they are recognized, how true they are to their word, how much they look out for their models, how much the CEOs actually work so hard to get these platforms for people who are under them. Now, if you see a place where they don't even make such efforts, why would you want to stress yourself and still make people still? The truth is, it's a very dicey thing. People make payments to join a modeling agency. And when you tell them you should join an academy, they tell you no, they've paid to join one agency or whatever. An academy is a schooling process. The agency is the agency. Like you just find yourself already going out for jobs and stuff. Like I know that, permit me to talk about Care and Footprint Academy, then why would I be here if I can't talk about it? I always tell my models, you have to go through classes for about 1 month without going for events or anything, even if we have anyone within that 1 month. Until after then, you can actually go out for us to see how confident you are, because we have to build on your confidence level first. Same goes for what I would have advised for a lot more people. But the point is, you've got to be in a team. You've got to belong somewhere. You've got to identify with some group to tell yourself, okay, you can't just wake up tomorrow and tell you I'm a freelance model. So what's your history? What, but there are some models, you ask them today, what's your statistics? They're looking at you like statistics. What's that? Which are things that you're supposed to have gotten from the schooling part of it? Which are things that you're supposed to have known before? When some people ask, if you ask some models, okay, what part of modeling do you focus on? Some people will be telling you, I'm a model. They don't even know if it's more of runway, if it's more of showcase, if it's more of commercials. Like, they don't have, you've just got to join an academy, get the right tutorials on what modeling entails, the do's and don'ts, and things you should know before you step into it to avoid a lot of scam in the system. Talking about portfolio, in our recent time, like those days we used to have it, I think, analog or stuff, you just have your album and stuff. But now, let me advise you models who are thinking of like breaking through the industry or creating a niche for yourself, don't stress it. You see your Instagram page, you see your social media pages generally, Facebook, Instagram, be careful, TikTok, whichever one, but Instagram to be precise. I think like a lot of potential clients are like flocking on Instagram. All your pictures, all your updates, they virtually take that as a portfolio. So you've got to do everything to boost your page, make sure the pictures are like top quality, top view. You've just got to like work on your social media presence. It's so important for models these days, because I know there are a lot of jobs you could miss because some other model has probably more following or more engagements or better picture quality or view arrangement of the page. Nowadays, the portfolio actually go beyond the previous analog thing. So just make sure your social media page is as rich as possible. Every job you've done, everything you've done, make sure you have it up there, showcasing who you really are, the kind of modeling you do. Whatever be the case, make sure your portfolio is up to standard alongside your social media pages. Secondly, you've got to network with other models. Like, that's like your focus. You're trying to be recognized as a model. You've got to move with like minds. So you've got to check out for models who are doing well. I'd not say if you see anybody that just put them a model on their Facebook status or Instagram, you follow. No. You've got to check out their portfolios, their history, the things they've done, things that make them recognize. See how they do it, see what they do, and network with these people. Make sure you're increasing your circle around that part of your interest. So it kind of like opens you to a world of opportunities and a world of possibilities. At the same time, I still want to advise models or people who want to become recognized models, especially in this time. You can't wait on your agency to always get the jobs. It's always nice when you go out for these opportunities. You see these things, you could even suggest to them, oh, I saw this thing online. I saw this event online. Can we try it? Can we do it? I'm sure that these CEOs will be happy about it. You've got to seek out opportunities yourself, to boost your profile. In fact, before you even think of boosting your profile, did I talk about you having a portfolio? The moment you join an agency, you've gotten the schooling you need, you are ready to step out into the public to show them what you've got, the first thing you have to do is to build your portfolio. Know your statistics, some very vital information people should have about you, because sometimes your body size, your smile, it could be your face, it could be part modeling, it could be your hand, it could be your lip, that somebody might need for an advert. You've not even gone so far, they'll tell you, oh, this is what I want. So you've got to build that portfolio that should be able to sell you out. Then scramble for these opportunities, like I advised. Go that extra mile, take that extra step. Then one other thing I would say is to be a very, let me just call it, successful model in Port Harcourt, or recognized model in Port Harcourt, is, you see, no model, any model that just tells you I'm a model. But I like what guys do these days. You ask a girl, what do you do? You tell them I'm a model, they tell you, and what? That's the truth. You've got to be doing something. You cannot be dulling. How can you? Are you selling your beauty? Like, modeling has gone beyond the beauty now, the physical beauty. Modeling is actually going into the beauty of the brain, the beauty of your confidence, the beauty of your poise. So you've got to be doing something else. Like, most models that are successful will probably go into hosting. Some of them are actually makeup artists. Some people are actually like crazy, a lot of crazy business ideas. You have to have something to sustain you, because trust me, you want to just do modeling, and only when you get modeling jobs, when you get something in your pocket, it only shows that you are definitely not a true model, because modeling itself is expensive. Modeling itself needs some financial sacrifices. So how do you maintain it? How do you keep to it? How do you keep that relevance or pull up more ideas that you can even explore if these financial backups are not there? You've got to be doing something. You've got to be known for something. Or she's a makeup artist, she's a host, or some people actually, like, there's someone into shoemaking. A lot of people do a lot of other things, but you cannot see. All I do is modeling. It's a lie. It's a huge lie. So if you really want to be successful in this town, you've got to have another side business running alongside modeling. Now, modeling is a window to market that business. Now, you become very well known as a model with a special skill. Now, I'm sure everybody wants to be on that path and not just, there's nothing much. You want to be a video vixen? Fine. For as long as you're getting the jobs constantly, always have a side business running. Modeling is so vast and beautiful in a way that you could do modeling in different kind of ways. You could do modeling and even still be a fashion designer. Like, you could actually run ambassadorial deals. Like, you could run 3-4 ambassadorial deals together, because all you're trying to do is marketing in the recent way, or in the 21st century way. Finally, I'll just drop this last one here. To be a recognizable model in Port Harcourt City, all those people that think that pride still sells market, I think you're missing it. Like, right now, nobody is even ready to deal with pride. Humility is like key. Manner of approach is like the strongest selling point. Like, you don't have a good manner of approach, everyone is just going to dump you like a bean. Humility is everything as a model. If you cannot be humble enough to meet a client and explain, some clients are like pretty rude, because at the end of the day, they are the ones dropping the money. So like they say, they are actually the king at the time. You allow them to do that. When you do your job and get your money, you just go. But the point is, how do you even increase your circle? How do you get more jobs? How do you get more referrals if the humility is missing? You just have to be humble in this town to actually... the other day I posted, I was like, loyalty actually is the key to making success in the entertainment industry. Trust me, it's called showbiz. You see the show part of it? It's so easy. People make a lot of noise, like Angel Dela said, on the show part of it. You think something is going on there, but they're just empty vessels. The business part of it is where you find the true models, is where you find the true entertainers, because that is where all the qualities of a good business person lies in. So when you talk about showbiz, you've just got to balance the both and make sure you're winning on the both sides. Humility is key. Manner of approach is key. Make sure you put that in check as a model. Make sure you're ready to listen. Make sure you don't take so much words to heart. People have the wrong notions about models these days. Do not feel terrible about it when they even tell you or refer to you as such. You could just smile about it, but you could change somebody else's reasoning or expressions or thoughts towards modeling just with the way you do, just with the way you act. So humility and the manner of approach is all I'll tell you. Use it to top the icing on the cake. Thank you guys for watching. I hope it has been able to help someone out there who's trying to be a recognized model, especially in this crazy city of Port Harcourt, because it really takes nothing. Like, models here are actually ready to network with you. Models here are ready to meet you. They're ready to help you. Like, they are with open arms to, like, grab you. Welcome to our team. You get, they're like really, really cool. They're not rude. But if you meet the wrong ones too, you definitely know you wouldn't go far. Keep your eyes open for the right circle. Catch you again on the next episode of QM Chronicles. Hope to see you next time. Girl about a 10, I should fuck her in the Benz. Make you say they run my town, don't know how I'm a prince. All we talk about is